What's going on, guys? It's your boy Ajen back again for another Neural Cloud video. And for today, it's November 20. And in less than 24 hours from now, the game will officially launch globally. Yes, I am excited for this one. But sadly, I am at work during that time. Sad. But I will still be able to play this one maybe during my break. And since there will be some auto features in the game, I might be able to grind this one. And also, FYI guys, the game is already available in the Play Store, so you can pre-download the game right now, but you will not be able to play the game just yet because it will be officially live tomorrow. So in this video, let us talk about rerolling, and should you reroll in the game? Short answer, no. If you've asked this in the official Neural Cloud Discord, they will respond to you by a bot saying that nope, it is not really recommended to reroll. You might be asking why it is not recommended to reroll. First of all, this game is pretty much a single PvE game. There are no PvP in this game, so there is really no advantage for you to be having a very strong start or all of the 3-star characters in the game. It will just give you an advantage in progressing further into the story. That just my opinion. That is one of the big advantage of rerolling in this one. And also, especially usually the F2Ps are the one that reroll the most because they really don't want to spend anything on the game and they want to get their hands on the strongest character available in the game, or maybe their favorite waifus or favorite husbandos in the game. That is one of the huge advantage of pre-rolling. The big disadvantage of pre-rolling is that it's very tedious, it's tiring, and you might get burnt out before you will be able to play the game. My advice is that just play through the campaign first and see for it that if you will enjoy the game, because some people try to reroll but in the end they quit maybe 1 or 2 days because the game is not for them. They don't like the game style, they don't like the battle system, yada yada. So play first before you decide if you will go for reroll for your favorite character or not. That is one tip that I can give you. For me, I will not be rerolling because I'm just gonna play the campaign, and the game seems very, very generous when it comes to resources, since we can also farm the shards. Dupes does not really matter because you can farm the shards, as I've said, and then they will just give you some form of tokens or shards, which is needed for your character's growth, for ascensioning your character to raising the star rarity, because the highest rarity in this game is 3 stars, so you need those character fragments to ascend your characters to 4-star and 5-star. It's probably the same, just like the one from Princess Connect Redive and Blue Archive. If you play those games, they are pretty much mostly the same. And also, you are guaranteed to get a 3-star in this game, because you will be given a 3-star selector. And let's talk about that one also while we're at it. So this is the 3-star selector guide by Mars, of course. Credits to Mars. So we have here the recommended characters, which is Nanaka, B, and Florence. So this girl is Nanaka, this girl is B, and this girl is Florence. Waifu, if you are a waifu player, who should you choose? I'm going to choose this one, Florence. But if you are a meta player, probably any of them is really, really good because it is a recommended one. And also, the best usage for your 3-star selector is to just hold on to them for now. Do not use it right away because you might be able to get the unit that you will choose in the 3-star selector. I don't think it has a time limit. I believe this one has no limit duration, so you can save this one until you've already gotten most of the characters here, Then you choose the one that you are currently missing. So why are these three a recommended one? So Nanaka is a premier healer and buffer. Procs medic cards constantly. Allies must stand within her radius to be healed or buffed. And best plays with 2 plus range DPS. So if you have if you will be able to get Hubble, then yeah, this one is a pretty good addition to Hubble, because Hubble is a range DPS. If you haven't watched my Who Should You Roll For, I've already published that one yesterday, so make sure to check that one out. And I've also published a beginner's guide. And B, infinite range, scales insanely well with warrior function cards. Both an operant or attack build are viable. Can crit via functions or other means. Pairs extremely well with Nanaka. High damage ultimate. So B and Nanaka are something like a combo wombo. So if you've already gotten Nanaka in your pools or B in your pools, then you might want to get Nanaka in your 3-star selector. Then we have Beer Florence, the one that I will be choosing if I won't be able to get her in my summons. Extremely powerful damage reduction buff out of the box. No skill levels necessary. Generally seen in 2 medic composition because she can only heal one target at a time. Pretty darn strong in if you're going to ask me. That is why probably she is recommended here, because there's no skill levels necessary. This one will save you a lot of resources, because if you level the skill, you are using resources to level the skills of the characters. So if this one does not really need the skill levels, then you save a lot. You can use those skill level up materials for your other characters. Next we have here the viable units, which is Evelyn, this eye patch girl, and the bubblegum girl, which is Banksy. So Evelyn is excellent in excellent passive damage reduction, strong crowd control against melee enemies, powerful team reposition and damage reduction ultimate, and passive is basically useless against range foes. So she's only good at against melee enemies. She's kinda niche, in my honest opinion. Croc is free and amazing though, so not a necessary pick. So we will be able to get Croc, a free unit. So that is why Evelyn is not a necessary pick in this 3-star selector. Next we have Banksy. Scales very well with both function cards and algorithms early and late game. Difficult to use because of her random movement. She procs debuff functions often, and then a unique accuracy evasion debuff that stacks with other standard blind effects. Fragments are available in Exception Protocol Shop. Pre-dull or quicker 5-star. Yeah, she's going to be pre also, but if you have the patience to wait, then she might not be a best choice to pick in your 3-star selector. And then lastly, we have these three characters here, which is Chansey, Centauracy, and Jin. I believe I butchered her name. Chansey, Centauracy, and Jin. So Chansey, early performance is average, single target damage less so, high AoE damage once built properly, and positional awareness required. No shortage of good snipers, so this pick is less appealing overall. So Chansey is a sniper, so yeah, if you already have a Hubble, if you will get Hubble, then you don't really need Chansey. Centauracy, strong crowd control in both passive and active skills, can be a strong asset early game if paired with 2 snipers. Most bosses can be stunned by her. Ultimate is a blockable skill shot, doesn't scale into late game well, overshadowed by better warriors. So yes, there will be some better choices, so do not pick her. If she's your waifu, then yeah, you might want to pick her. Then we have Virgin. Probably the only husbando that is available in this 3-star selector pick. Procs medic cards often, strong against DOT damage. Early performance is lacking, but scales into late game builds well. Nanaka is an overall better pick. So yeah, if you don't have Nanaka, then Nanaka is still the best pick out of these 3-star selectors. And yes, these are free. You will be able, we will be all be able to get this one, but you will only be able to pick one. So choose wisely with this one. And that is why I don't think it is really necessary to reroll, because most characters available in the game, especially the free characters, are pretty much viable in progressing into the campaign or in the game. So yes, rerolling is probably a hassle. It's probably something with the delete data and download again, but there is a way around that one. If you have a rooted phone, you might be able to reroll for a faster one, but I have no idea how to reroll, but I'm not going to reroll. That is what I will be doing tomorrow when the game launches. So what about you guys? Would you reroll or not? Anyways, that's it for me for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave a like and subscribe. I would really appreciate it if you could help me grow my channel more. And thank you to everyone who are supporting my channel. I appreciate every one of you. Until next time, peace!